Andre, and Miss O'Keefe. And today is our biology session about chapter 5, lesson 1. Let's start it. Okay. Chapter 5, lesson 1 is called Sensitivity in the Living Organisms. Sensitivity in the Living Organism in lesson 1 starts with sensitivity in plants. Characteristics of the living organism. The living organism has many characteristics like movement, respiration, sensitivity, growth, reproduction, excretion, and nutrition. In this lesson, we're going to talk about sensitivity. What's sensitivity? Sensitivity is one of the functions done by a living organism to keep its life or to maintain its life. Okay? Sensitivity. In animal, it's more obvious than in plant, and the human reach the highest efficiency and accuracy in sensitivity. So, my dear students, pay attention, please. Sensitivity is one of the functions of the living organism to keep its life. Sensitivity more obvious in animal than in plant. And finally, human at the top. Human reach the highest efficiency and accuracy in sensitivity. To solve this question, choose the correct answer. The opposite graph illustrates three different levels of sensation for three living organisms. This graph illustrates three different living organisms. Okay, which choice represents X, which Y, and which Z respectively? A. Gorilla, sunflower, octopus. B. Sunflower, gorilla, octopus. C. Sunflower, octopus, gorilla. D. Octopus, gorilla, and sunflower. Pay attention. Which is the most? Y is the most. So Y must be gorilla, and X is the least. So it's what? It's sunflower, as it's a plant, and Z in the middle, which is octopus. So respectively, X must be, yeah, sunflower. After it, Y, which is the most excellent of a gorilla, and finally octopus. So the correct answer is what? Is B. Sunflower, gorilla, and octopus. Okay. Another question. The vital function that help the living organism to adapt with its environment is what? Respiration, transpiration, movement, sensation. Attention, vital function help the living organism to adapt with its environment is what? Excellent. It's sensation for the adaptation. Yeah? So now, what's sensitivity? Sensitivity is the response of the living organism to internal or external stimuli with a suitable response to maintain its life. So the definition of sensitivity, response of a living organism to maintain an internal or external stimuli with suitable response. The response suitable to the external stimuli or the internal stimuli to maintain the life. In this lesson, we are going to talk about sensitivity in plant. Sensitivity in plant includes two things. Number one, response to touch and darkness. Number two, through presence. Sensitivity in plant is less obvious than human, and it can be clear in response to touch and darkness or through presence. In response to touch and darkness, like this one, this is a type of plant which is called mimosa. Mimosa plant responds to touch and darkness in it is obvious in the leaflets of mimosa plant. So sensitivity clear in mimosa plant leaflets. Firstly, know the morphology of mimosa plant to know how sensitivity occurs in it. Mimosa plant, this is more details about the structure of mimosa plant. السي وذس ميموزا بلانت consists the leaves of mimosa plant are what? They are compound and also pinnated. The leaves are compound and pinnated. There is something called primary ridges. This is called the primary ridges. The primary ridges which carry four secondary. Okay, this is primary. Carry what? Carry four secondary ridges. But this is the primary ridges which carry four secondary ridges. Okay, and the end of secondary ridges carry two row of leaflets. Okay, this is two row of leaflets. Okay, at the base of each primary and secondary ridges there is a swollen structure. The secret is here, and the swollen structure in the mimosa plant, which is called fulvus. So the bulbous, which is found at the base of each leaflet, has a chemical substance, has a secret of idea of working the mimosa plant. Okay, let's see the link. I send you the link to watch it after this session. Here, please. Watch it. Okay. This will show you how the action of mimosa. Okay. Now, this is the shape of mimosa plant before touching, and now it's after touching it. What happened? What happened to the leaflets of mimosa after touching? After touching the mimosa plant, what happened? The petioles soon drop. This is called petioles drops, and it has wilted. And other neighboring petioles soon follow till the effect is seen in all the leaflets. To start with one and finally end in all the leaflets. Okay? What happened in the daytime? Daytime, as you touch it, the leaflets are held in horizontal position, wake up. It's called wake up movement. But at night, it's called sleep movement. So it responds to what? Responds to touch and darkness. At the daytime, it's wake, but at the night, it's what? Sleep. Okay? To know how the leaflets fall down and explain its movement, what this? This is leaflet, and this is the bulbous. By touching or at night, the bulbous does work at the joint. This joint between each two bones. And here in the plant, bulbous work at the joint. What happened? The cell wall of the bulbous at the lower half of the bulbous shrink. Look here, this is the bulbous. The cell wall of the lower half shrink, and what's happened? The water fall to the neighboring tissue, and what? And hence the leaflet drop. This is at day, and this is at night. What happened at night? At night, or after touching the mimosa plant, the leaflet of the cell wall of the lower half of the bulbous shrink, and water move to the neighboring tissue, and hence the leaflet drop. So when the stimulus removed, what happened? The cell regain their turgidity, and the leaflet open once more. Okay, it's a cross-sectional view in the mimosa leaflet, okay, showing the bulbous and how it works, and the cell wall of the lower half shrink leads to water to move in the neighboring tissue, and after removing the stimulus, what happened? It regained their turgidity and the leaflet opened once more. Okay, this is the first type, which is called response of plant to touch and number two, tropism. What's tropism? Tropism mean curvature. So basically, mean the curvature in the plant. The roots of the root, the plant consists of what? Consists of root system and shoot system. Okay? The growth of roots and stem depend on many factors, which are light, humidity, and finally gravity. And these factors are exerted on the sides of the stem or the root. When this factor exerted in the sides of the stem or the root in an equal form, curvature happens. So curvature, which is tropism, is what? There are three types of tropism: photo, geo, hydro, cold, light, humidity, and gravity. There are three factors, so there are three types of tropism. Phototropism is the bending of plant towards light. So what's phototropism, which is the first type, is the bending of plant towards what? Yeah, towards light. Plants may be positive or negative phototropism, or the part of plant may be positive or negative. Note this, do an experiment, place a straight seedling, okay, and put it in a light-proof box. Light-proof box with a circular hole at one of each side, and to allow light to pass, like this. This is box, and this is the hole, and this is the source of light. What do you observe? The stem inclined towards the source of light, and the root inclined away from the source of light. So the stem is called positive phototropism, okay? Or the root is called negative phototropism. First type first is phototropism, okay? To show this, we put a stem in a box. This box made of opaque material, or a dark, which is called a light-proof box or opaque material with a hole, and allow the source of light to penetrate. What's happened? After several days, the root go away from the source of light, and the stem go toward the source of light. So the stem is called positive phototropism, and the root is called negative phototropism. Okay? This is the root, positive, and the stem, negative, okay? Let's show this question. The opposite figure illustrates an experiment which is used to prove the effect of light on the growth of three plant seedlings. So there is three seedlings. Which of the following figure illustrate the opposite result of the response of seedling after passing several days? These seedlings, number one, decapitated with decapitated calyptile. Number two, the calyptile covered with a plaque cover, which is opaque substance. Number three, seedling with a calyptile tip. Okay, and this is opaque box with a source of light from one direction from the right side. What happened after passing several days? Think. What do you think? The decapitated. There is no calyptile. There is no calyptile, so there is no curvature. And this, there is a plaque substance or a plaque cover, so there is no curvature. There is no sensation to the light. Okay. Number three, the seedling, the only one which in which the phototropism. Here, so the stem and the calyptile tip move towards what? Yeah, move towards light. Which is choices? Yeah, this is wrong because the second one just positive, and this is wrong. B, yeah, I think B is right. So C wrong and D also wrong. So the correct answer is yeah, is B. Please, my dear teachers, try to think about the component of this, the drawing, and think what it is to know the correct answer. Think before answering. Okay. Number two, explanation of the phototropism. What is the reason of the phototropism? Okay, the scientist Poisson Johnson found the explanation of the phototropism. And it is what? The secretin, the chemical substance found in the chemical, which is called auxin. Poisson Johnson do its experiments on the old killing child. The old killing child loses its ability to bend its world in the light if we cut the killing child. If you cut from one to two millimeters of the tip, okay? If we cut the killing child, there is no curvature. But this killing child, when it's restored, when it's booked again and put a gelatin disc, it returns its ability to do phototropism. But when we put mica, there is no curvature. So the calyptile, when we cut the calyptile, there is no curvature of that. When we put this using gelatin, there is curvature. But when we put it and fix it with a mica sheet, what's happening? There is no curvature. This is the experiment of Poisson Johnson to know how phototropism works. Okay? What happened? This is the chemical and this is the auxin. This is the plant moving straight line. But here, the light is just in one direction. So, the light in this direction, so the auxin move away from the source of light. Yeah, auxin move away, and film elongation occurs. And this is called the positive phototropism of the stem. So this diagram illustrates what happened. The auxins move away from the source of light, okay? And so film elongation occurs in the stem, and the stem is called the positive phototropism. The tip of the calyptile contain chemical substance called auxin. The main one of this auxin is called indole acetic acid. So indole acetic acid is one of the main chemical substances in the auxins. Okay, and curvature occurs due to the unequal growth of the two sides. This is the two sides, grow and equal side. But here there is unequal growth. So curvature occurs in the stem or in the root. Okay. And another scientist called Wendt. Wendt put his experiment to prove the validity of Poisson Johnson experiment. So number one, Poisson Johnson, and Wendt to prove the validity of it. Okay? Wendt exposed an old calyptile to the light from one side. Okay? And cut it. Look. He cut the calyptile, then placed it onto agar block. Put it into agar block. From here, put it in agar block. Okay? And separated the two agar block, separated by mica. Yeah, I can draw here. Two agar block. And this is mica to separate between them. Okay? Okay. Okay, this is two agar block. But experiment, when you cut the killing time after putting it in the light from one side. Yeah, and cut the tip and placed it onto a agar block, separated by a mica sheet. This is a mica sheet, and also this is a mica sheet. And he measured the concentration of auxin in each one, okay? And put it, okay? What he found that the concentration of auxin away from the light in the side, which is away from the side, is more, 65%. But in the right, which is near the light, is what is 35%. So the concentration of oxygen is more away from the source of light. Okay. So objects move from the side facing light to the darkened one. Okay, let's solve this experiment, this question. Yeah. To accurate distribution of oxygen in of oxygen in the tip of wood colophon is exposed to light. Which one is accurate? Which concentration is accurate when the sun from exposed to the light from the right side? This is the right side. So the oxygen is what? Move away. Where is one? Which one? Which one? Yes, here. A, the oxygen. More air, the left. So because source of light is here in the right side. So when the source of light here, yeah. This is the source of light from the right side. So what? So the oxygen move away from it. Okay. So the correct answer is the accurate distribution of oxygen is number A. Okay. The question. When carrying out an experiment to verify the hypothesis, a stem of plant was exposed to light from one side. This is the stem and exposed from one side only, which is the right one also. Which of the illustration region in the opposite figure had the highest rate of growth? High concentration of oxygen, high rate of growth. Okay, which one? X, Y, Z, or L? Yeah, this is the source of light here. So the position is what? Or the highest rate of growth in the region, what? In the region Z. So the correct answer is Z. Now to know the behavior of the root and stem toward the unidirectional illumination. What's meant by unidirectional illumination? Mean illumination from just one side, not the two sides. Okay? Stem is called positive phototropism because it bends towards the light. And root is called negative phototropism, which bends away from the light. Why? Why stem is positive? Because of its move from the side facing the light of the stem to the non-illuminated side, which is called the dark side. And illumination of the far side is more than of the lighted side. Okay. Root, the opposite root, also the opposite. Pay attention, my dear students. Here, what is this? This is plant, root, stem, and this is the root. This is the source of light. Oxygen on the plant exposed to a source of light from just one direction, oxygen move away. So what happens when the oxygen move away? When the oxygen move away, let's draw to illustrate. Yeah, okay. When the oxygen move away from the source of light, what happens? This side happens at elongation, and it's called positive phototropism. So the elongation is more in the side which away from the source of light, and this is in the stem. Yeah, excellent. It is in the stem. But in the root, what happened? More often lead to less growth. In the stem, more often lead to more growth, but in the root, more oxygen leads to what? Leads to less growth. So stem is called negative. It's called negative phototropism because the more oxygen causes less growth. Okay? It's in the stem. In the root, sorry. Okay, so the plant is positive, when the plant is faced a light from one side, this is called phototropism, curvature occurs called phototropism. The stem is called positive phototropism, and the root has negative phototropism. Okay, this is about the first type of tropism, which is called phototropism. Number two, geotropism. What geotropism? Geotropism like putatropism. What? Yeah, geotropism. Geotropism. Geotropism is what it was believed that the geotropism, the root of the plant, go downward in order to avoid the light and seeks for nutrients. But this is incorrect. What the when the plant is hanged, when we hang a pot, what happened? The root go vertically downward and the stem grow upward. Okay. Geotropism is the response of the plant to external stimuli, to gravity, and move away from or toward the stimulus. So geotropism, the tropism of the response of the plant part to external stimuli. What this experiment? In this experiment, we put a plant and germinate a number of seeds in the soil, and that we know that the thumbnails of the plant grow upward. But the radicals move downwards, okay? So the stem is negative. Stem is negative what? Geotropism. And the root is positive one, positive geotropism. Look here. The augments move away from the, move towards the gravity, according to the gravity. So in the root, what happened? In the root, more augments lead to less growth, but in the stem, more oxygens lead to more growth. Okay. Okay. What is the opposite figure illustrates growing seeds of pea plant with radical. This radical placed horizontally. Okay. Where it was placed on the rotating disc. This is a rotating disc. Vertically in a slow manner. So for 3 days. What happened? What happened to the radical? Is it grow this or it moved downwards? Because there is no rotation. Because there is a rotation, what happened? The radical stay as it is. So the correct answer is A. Because there is no ability to geotropism to happen. There is no geotropism. Okay, so this is what? This is the correct answer is number B, which is number A, which is okay. After that, finally, the hydrotropism. What's hydrotropism? Like phototropism and geotropism, it's the response of the plant to external stimuli, which is humidity. When the plant, what? Humidity. But if we put a plant seedling, okay, in the soil, and this is a moist soil, so the root move downward and the stem upward. But when the water is just in one direction, what happened? The root move toward water, but and this is called positive, what? Positive hydrotropism. Okay, so the root is positive hydrotropism. Finally, the root is positive hydrotropism, and there is no effect on the stem. And the phototropism, stem is positive, and the root is negative. Geotropism, stem is negative, and the root is positive. Okay. Finally, thank you for good listening, and waiting for you for the next session. Okay. Thank you.